Hello guys, this tutorial will be on improving the projectiles. The projectiles that our player shoots when he's on cat form. So if I'm a cat, he shoots a projectile. But these projectiles have several flaws. The first one is that they don't inherit the velocity of the player. We're going to make an option for that. Another thing is that they can collide with the flowers, and because the flowers are good, they shouldn't hit the fur ball when they collide with it. And also we'll make the fur balls not collide with themselves. And finally, you see this right here? When I throw this, if you recall, the meow sound comes from whenever I shoot the fur ball, and whenever the fur ball is deleted, the meow sound stops. And we don't want that. So the first thing that we're going to do is to make the fur ball not collide with himself and with the flower. So by the way, make sure that the flower that you have here is a prefab, so that you can drag several flowers into the scene like that. Anyways, let's create a tag for the flower called flower, and also a tag for the fur ball called fur ball, and apply them. So click on the flower on the prefabs, go on to the untagged and change it to flower, and in the fur ball, go on to the tag and change it to fur ball. Now in the Furball script, so in the furball, you go here into the furball script, let's open it, and we're going to make the furball not collide with the flower and with itself. So all you have to do is to add two more conditions in an if clause, in a else if clause that we have there. So right now the furball doesn't get deleted whenever it collides with the player. And whenever it collides with something with a tag flower, it also won't be deleted. And when it doesn't collide with something with a tag furball, it won't be deleted. This way, whatever the furball is colliding with isn't a player, or isn't a flower, or isn't a furball, then the furball is destroyed. So let's save this. Let's go into Unity, hit play, and you can see right now that if I go into a flower, if I throw the furball into a flower, it doesn't collide with it, which is exactly what we wanted. Now let's make the furball adopt the velocity of the player, and we could do this in the player script. So here in this evolution script in the player, which we made in the last tutorial, and it's in this script that the furball gets instantiated and that it's given a velocity with. We could just put here a plus the game object dot rigid value to the dot velocity dot x of the player, and that will be fine, and it will work fine. I'm going to try to make it in here because it's a bit more complicated, and I'm going to show you how to do it. Anyways, let's create here a public bool called adopt speed, and in the start function, if adopt speed equals true, then we want to be added to the speed of the furball, the speed of the player. But right now, and how can I get the player? Well, supposedly if I put here public game object player, and then I drag the player into here, I could access it and put it and apply the velocity of the player into here. But let me show you something. If I save this, and in Unity, where is the furball? And then if I go into the furball, here it is. There it is, and if I try to drag the player into that thing that we just created, it won't be dragged. Why? Well, because the furball is in the prefabs folder, and when something is in the prefabs folder, you can drag something from the scene into one of its fields. So what we're going to do is to make the script find something with the tag player, and then make it this game object. So just put it like this. And in the start function, if the adopt speed is true, we want the player to be equal to the game object, like this, with the capital G dot find with tag, and the tag will be the player tag. So it finds the player like this, and it sets the player to be the player in this script, and then we can now make the velocity of the fur ball be adopted. So game object dot rigid y to the dot velocity, which is the velocity of the fur ball, plus equals, and we're going to make here a new vector 2, because we only want the velocity of the player influence the x of the x velocity, not the y, so the y will be 0, and the x will be equal to the player dot game object dot rigid y to the dot velocity dot x, and that should work right now. Let's see. Save it, go into Unity, play. Right now it isn't checked, so it still won't adopt the velocity. But if I go into the furball script and I click here on the adopt speed, then it should adopt the speed. So as you can see, it now adopts the speed, but not the Y speed. Because if I jump and try to press, it still goes forward and not in diagonal ways and stuff like that. So the only thing that's left to take care of is the mouse sound not playing sometimes till the end, because the furball collides with the wall and deletes itself, and the meow sound isn't played. So all we have to do is whenever we destroy the furball, instead of just destroying, we're going to create here a function void destroy it. And in this function, what we're going to do is, first we're going to make the trigger of the furball inactive. So collider2d dot enabled equals false, so that the furball can't collide with anything else. Also, we're going to make the sprite of the furball inactive, so that we can't see the furball. So it's just like it's not really there, the furball, but we still want to play the sound, so it has to be there in some way, so it will be invisible. Anyways, to make the sprite go away, just type game object dot get component, and the component will be the sprite render component, and remember it to put in between this greater and less sign parentheses over there. By the way, if you want, you can find the reference for this get component thing in the description. And we want to access the enabled field of the sprite render, which is this little button over here, because if I press this little button on the furball won't be visible. So dot enabled, that's the enabled button, equals false, and then we want to destroy the furball. Destroy, but not immediately, because if it is destroyed immediately, the meow sound won't play. So this dot game object is destroyed after, let's say, 2 seconds. I think that's fine, that's enough time for the furball, for the meow sound to play. Save it. Now whenever we type here destroy, we want to replace it with destroy it. So here destroy it, here destroy it, and that's it. We haven't destroyed the furball anywhere else. So right now save it, and I can hit play, and we have fixed all of the problems. As you can see, now the sound plays until the end, and the furball still is there, as you can see in there, until the 2 seconds pass, and then the furball gets deleted. One last thing that we're going to do is to instantiate a particle system whenever the furball hits a wall. So first off, let's create that particle system. So here, click on game object, particle system, and we have here a particle system, but these particles over here are not the ones that we want. What you want is little furballs to throw with on. So go on to the sprites folder, and we have here this furball, and we're going to make a copy of it. So Ctrl D to make a copy. And in this copy, you want to make it from a sprite to a texture. Apply, and I'll drag this texture into the particle system that we just created. Oh, by the way, before doing that, make alpha is transparent so that the background isn't seen. So drag it into the particle system. Now the particles are little furballs. Now there's something wrong with it, which is the shader over here. Want to make it a sprite's default shader so that they are normal. Now we want the duration of this to be like really slow, really almost none. The looping to be non-existent, the particles to be like 100, and now in the emission, we're going to make a small burst of like 20 particles, right at time 0, and the rate will be 500. And the rate is basically the amount of particles that are shot per second, so this will make it like real quick to explode, like this. Like I'm going to show you right now. As you see, big burst. But that's not quite what you want, is it? No, want it to be like want to have it less particles. So here where it says max particles, decrease it a bit. Something like 15. Okay, that's fine. And as you can see, the particles are a bit too big, so change the size a bit to, let's see, 0.1 maybe. That's a bit too small, 0.3. Okay, that's fine. And now let's give it some gravity. Okay. Maybe less. And the last thing that we're going to do is to go into the shape and change it from a cone to a hemisphere so that it explodes like everywhere except down, but they will end up down in there. And that's a good particle system. So make sure that looping is unchecked and drag this particle system into the prefabs folder. There you go. And in the furball script, let's put here another reference for the furball, for the particle system. So public game object explosion. Just like that. And that explosion will be the particle system, and we want to instantiate the particle system in the destroyed function. So in here, want to instantiate the explosion at distance from dot position. So game object dot transform dot position, and with no rotation, so quaternion dot identity, like so. And let's now put the particle system into the furball. So where's the furball? There it is. Here's the script, and drag it into the explosion field. So particle system into the explosion field, like that. And one last thing that we want to do is in the particle system add a component, and this is a script that I've already created, which is this one, destroy by time, which will destroy the particle system after 1 second, because we don't want the particle system to remain there in the scene. This way it gets destroyed. I can even show you the script. It's just this. Whenever the explosion is started, it destroys it after some time. It's just like that. Anyways, save all this. Let's hit play. And if I get a flower, and if I throw the furball into something, and see, this explodes into some cool particles, and they are a bit too big. I can make them smaller. So in the prefabs particle system size, make it 0.15 maybe. Play, and now that's it for today, guys. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next tutorial.